Hi folks, welcome back. This is Arlene. What we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and continue cutting this tree portion out. So what you want to do is make sure your glove is on and your thumb guard, and we're just going to follow this all the way around on each side. All these lines that we put on for where the tree is, I put a little curvature on there just to give it some character. What you're going to do is you're going to take a knife and you're going to cut that out. Let me get my knife here, and you're just going to sliver this portion out like so. Okay, if it's not deep enough, you go back and make another pass. Okay, just like so. You can hear it cutting, and then what you want to do is you just want to cut this up, cut that portion out. Piece just doesn't want to come out. There we go. Technically, you're not supposed to do that. Pry it out like that, but what you want to do is just take your time, take the edge of your knife, the point of your knife, and go up there and cut it out. Now you can go in pretty deep. I started up here as well. Those brown sections there will go away when you paint them. I'll paint a little gesso, which is a sealer, over top of it first, and I'll paint it the green color that I want. The way I'm going to paint this thing is through what's called a wash. So what's also important, when you get this cut out, you see there's a little bit of a difference between what you cut and what the block looked like. What you want to make sure you do is you shave all that off, okay? When you get to the point where you're almost done with your carving, you want to go back and just sliver all that off so it looks the same. Because if you don't and you go to paint it, it's going to look different. It's not going to be consistent, because I don't do any sanding on these. I just allow the cuts of the knife to be part of it. As you can see, I've been working on the tassel here. So what we're going to do is something a little different. So let me go back. So you're going to do all three tiers like this, or all this one, and this one. The same way, you're going to go back up and you're going to cut it out. The other thing we're going to do is we're going to round the corners off. Okay, I'm going to round this off, and you got to be careful because the grain is running this way and this stuff can snap off just like it did. So you want to make sure your knife is nice and sharp. Round it to where you want it to be. You have your center line as a reference point, okay? And what you want to do is you just want to slice all that out and just make it round. Round those corners up really well. And if you go a little deeper on the section of the tree above it, just cut it out. It's pretty simple. Okay? Alright. I probably won't get this done before the new year. This will probably get done in 2010, which is great. I'm looking forward to a new year. So what you want to do is you want to have all this, basically, each corner you want cut up. And here too, when you start cutting this up, you're going to cut underneath this tassel, and you're just going to slice it out. And you make it a little deeper all the way around here. I'm trying to find a little scoop here. I use one of these little tiny gouges. I don't know if you're familiar with these little palm gouges, but this is what I use to get up in here. And you see, it's almost the same curvature. Let me bring this up. It's almost the same curvature as the Santa. Not quite, but what you want to do is go from either side and just dig that out a little bit. Okay, just like so. Okay, you just want to make that a little bit deeper. If that doesn't work, then you just take your knife in there to cut it out. Sometimes I hold the knife like a pencil when I do this. It's not recommended to hold a knife like that, but in certain times when you carve, it's important to get that corner, and then you can take your knife up there just like so and cut that out nice and clean. Alright, so when we're doing this corner is going to go out a little further, and we're just going to put it up underneath that tassel there. We're going to just work on that a little bit. Okay, and the tassel is going to be separated here where the white ball is. So we're going to just cut that, and we're going to just put a little cut like that, and we're going to do another one Another stop cut. Okay. Now the other thing is you might want to cut a little bit more up here where technically it's going underneath this other portion of the tree. So this might be a little bit deeper. So I'm going to do some of this offline where I can see it just a tad better, better than here. And I have great expectations for 2010, people. I do. I'm looking forward to another great, good year. The first part of my year wasn't so hot, but the second year definitely was much better. And I guess we all can say there are parts of 09 we like to forget and other parts we like to remember. Just remember the good stuff, folks. All right, well, there we go. See how we got that underneath there? So what I want to do here is I want to really make this distinct where this tassel goes. And then this tassel is going to be rounded off. I'm going to do that right now on the front portion of it anyway. And be careful how you cut that, because remember the grain is running this way. Okay? You want to be careful. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just cut that tassel in a little further. Give it some distinction from the tassel to part of that hat. Okay? Just like so. That's all you need to do. You don't need to make it real deep, but you just want to make it distinctive that it's separated from one to the other. Okay? I know I got a glare here. I don't know why I have that, but there we go. I'm going to go a little deeper. Okay. Cut that out a little rounder. And then this is going to be all rounded up. I'm going to cut this up a little further and clean this up here at the corner up here. And then we'll round that ball up on our next segment.